So friends, let's discuss a new story on Bipin Chaudhary's lapse of memory from the Honeydew Tech Standard 8. So let's start with the story. Now before we go into the story, you should know who was Satyajit Ray. So he was mainly born on May 1921 and he died on 1992. He was widely regarded as one of the greatest filmmakers of the 20th century. He was also a fiction writer, illustrator, publisher, calligrapher, graphic designer, and film critic. He has written several short stories and novels for children, adolescents, and also he has been a cultural icon for Indians and the Bengali community worldwide. Sorry that CA is not there actually. Let's move on with the story now. You can find the picture right on the screen. So, here it goes as part 1. Now in this part 1, every Monday, story starts like this. Bipin Chaudhary used to visit the new market at Kali Charan to buy books. His interest lay in crime stories, ghost stories and thrillers. So he mainly liked this types of short stories and he had a craze for reading. He lived alone and did not have any friends. But one day at Kali Charan, he had a feeling that somebody was observing him closely. The man looked at Bipin Babu and smiled, but Bipin Babu could not recognize him. The man reminded him that they had met in Ranchi in 1958. And he had arranged a car for him to the Hoodoo Falls. The man introduced him as Parmil Ghosh. So you can come across a new character, Parmil Ghosh, after Bipin Chandra. So let's move on with the next slide. You can see at Kali Charan, Bipin Babu had a feeling that someone was observing him. So you can see over here. And thus he meets Parmil Ghosh over there. Bipin Babu was sure he had never been to Ranchi. Parmil cited various instances, but Parmil Ghosh wanted to make him believe that he had visited Ranchi once. So he starts giving different instances, different incidents where he had met. So, and reminds him of the days spent there. He told him that he had a fall in Hoodoo. So once when they had gone for visiting Hoodoo Falls, he had accidentally fell over there and he had got injured on his right knee. Parmil had brought iodine and fixed up a car for him to go to Netrat. That is another tourist center or place where they were ready to go for the visit. But he could not make it due to the cut. So as he got injured on the right knee, he could not travel there. Parmil once again urged. So you can see there. Parmil again, he is making an urge and desire to know about it. Bipin Babu to recall the incident. So he wants Bipin Babu to go imagine that incident, to recall the incident. But this Bipin Babu was sure that he has never visited the place. He told him about one Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee, the third character, in whose house he had stayed. He also reminded him that he carried a bag full of books on his sightseeing trips and had big arguments about the moon landing. So they had also discussed a new character, that is Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee. So even they had a conversation of the moon landing and they had a big argument. Then they were discussing about sightseeing trips and all. Bipin Babu could not recollect anything, but although this narration, after listening to all this narration from Parmil Ghosh, he is not at all accepting the truth that he had come to Ranchi once. He informed the man that he was mistaken and that around the time in October 1958, he was in Kanpur with a friend. So he is trying to make out the date that he had reached Ranchi, as Parmir Ghosh is telling him that he had reached Ranchi on that particular date. So he's trying to recollect that if he had gone somewhere on that particular day. So when he was recollecting his memory, he was sure that he had gone with his friend to Kanpur. Parmir told him that he had no children and his wife had died 10 years ago. His only brother had died insane in a mental hospital in Ranchi. Now he is again getting confused. Now Bipin Babu is somewhat got into the trap of Parmir Ghosh, because he starts giving incident, the real life incident that had happened in the life of Bipin Babu, as yet there's no children, then about his wife, he's mentioning about his wife, his brother who got insane and was admitted to the mental hospital, and all those information is given, and Bipin Babu had no recollections of any such incidents which previously was in narrated to Bipin Babu. Still he is getting confused now. Then you can see in the part 2 section, you can see in the picture, he is getting confused, he is having a lot of questions in his mind and he is going on getting into it. Okay, now let's check with the next part, that is part 2. Bipin Babu regretted having paid so much attention to the stranger, for he was sure his excellent memory. So now he started thinking why he is trying to believe the person he has never met. Okay, although he is having an excellent memory, he is working in a reputed company and he never forgets things, then what if it is necessary to go on thinking about all the conversations that they had before with the Parmir Ghosh? So he starts go on thinking, and he even thinks that after some point of time he will become crazy with it. But the thought of the stranger knowing so many intimate details about his wife's death, brother's madness, etc. nagged him. He was sure that at that time he was at his friend Haridas Bhagichi's place in Kanpur. Bipin Babu could write to Haridas about confirming, but he remembered that Haridas had left for Japan with his wife. He examined an inch long cut mark on his knee, but had no idea of how and when he had got it. Bipin Babu then he decided to visit Dinesh Mukherjee to establish Parmil's claim that Dinesh Mukherjee was there in Ranchi at the same time. So he now wants to negotiate about all these things. He confirmed that Bipin Babu was there in Ranchi at that time. Bipin Babu lost his appetite and was sure that he had lost his memory. So now he has almost gone into the trap. You can see how he is thinking. Now let's move on with part 3. Bipin Babu could not concentrate on his work in office. Now he has lost his concentration on the work he was doing. And he was a hardworking person. He found it utterly impossible that not one incident related to Ranchi could be remembered. He is trying hard to go to remember such things, but still he is not getting into sight. He can't remember the things. So what happens? He left from home early and lay in his bed to gather the thoughts. So he is trying to gather all the thoughts. Okay. And finally what happens, his old friend Chunni Babu came to him. He was a schoolmate and now he was looking for a job and wanted his favor from Bipin Babu. But Bipin Babu knew that it was impossible to do anything for Chunni Babu. He really did not wanted to help Chunni Babu, as he declined to see him. The thought struck Bipin Babu that Chunni Babu might remember something about the Ranchi trip. Chunni recalled that it was he who had done his railway booking for Ranchi and had seen him off at the station. This came as a blow to him and he decided to see a doctor about his memory loss, considering this as a serious matter. Now he understands something serious has been gone and I have got a memory loss. I have lost 1 or 2 years. He consulted a physician that the another character that comes into it, that is Paresh Chanda. He is a physician who himself was confused about it but suggested that he make a trip to Ranchi. It might work and he might get back his lost memory. Okay. The same evening, Bipin Babu left for Ranchi. Now, finally, we come to the conclusion of the story, that is part 4. On reaching Ranchi, Bipin Babu realized that none of the places had any acquaintance with him. Nothing stirred his memory. Nothing stirred his memory. He decided to visit Hoodru Falls. There, two Gujarati gentlemen discovered Bipin Babu lying unconscious beside a boulder. Next morning, he returned to Calcutta. Then what happens? That is the final conclusion of the story. There he sent for Dr. Chanda as he could not visit him. So he invited Dr. Chanda to his house for an examination. A servant meanwhile brought a letter. So you can find in the next slide, a letter was being brought there, which was for Bipin Babu marked urgent and confidential. You can see the green envelope there. On the top of it, it's written urgent and confidential. Urgent and confidential. You can see the top written on it. Okay. And here you can see it was from Chunni Lal. So this particular letter, it was written by Chunni Lal to Bipin Babu. And this is the content of the letter. You can see over there. He had written that he had fallen on bad days and had counted on Bipin Babu to help him, but he was a changed man now. He had no money but had imagination, which he used to punish Bipin Babu for his insensitive and indifferent behavior. He further added that one novel of his might get published and bring him fortune to last for some time. Bipin Babu told Dr. Chanda that his memory had come back and now he wanted the doctor to prescribe a painkiller for his hip pain as he had fallen in Ranchi. So this is the story, and you can see finally Chunni Lal teaches a life lesson to Bipin Babu. See that they were childhood friends, right? So you should not forget, whenever you reach a success, whenever you reach your success, you should never forget your past. You should never forget your friends. When somebody comes for help and you are capable of helping them, then you should never deny it. So that is the life lesson that Chunni Lal wants to give to Bipin Babu. So that's it for today. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, bye.